Hi. My name is Rohan. I have anxiety. To people here who might not know what that is, I'll use a simple definition. What this means is that as part of my life, I am constantly, persistently, and excessively worried about all sorts of actions and events, no matter how ordinary or how routine those events may be. So I guess what I'm saying is standing on an island with no escape, with 1,000 people staring at me, is a very relaxing way to spend the evening. Anxiety is a difficult thing to explain to people because when you start to describe it, or when I start to describe it, most people listen for a bit and then say, but it sounds like you're just worried about things. Everybody has worries. Tough shit, son. You're not special. Have you read a newspaper recently? Everybody has problems, but that's just it. Anxiety is not just worry. Have you ever left home and wondered if you forgot to switch the geyser off? Have you ever been to a restaurant where the menu is so large and has so many things on it that it paralyzes you into indecision and you can't even decide what you want to drink? Now imagine going to a restaurant where the menu is that large and it has that many options, except every single option on the menu is another geyser that you forgot to switch off. That terror, but every single minute of every single day about every little thing, that's anxiety. As someone who lives with anxiety, I'm really glad that people are finally talking about anxiety. As someone who has anxiety, I really hate that people want to talk about anxiety to me. When you tell me about your anxiety, all you're doing is ensuring that now I'm worried about me and about you. And that's the thing, I understand and I empathize. And the thing is, I want to help you and I want to help everybody. And I would carry everybody's shit in a heartbeat if I was strong enough. But some days I feel like I have the strength to do it. Some days I feel like I can help somebody look into their abyss. I can help people stare down their abyss without blinking until the abyss blinks first. But on other days, I'll help somebody stare into their abyss and realize that their abyss looks way too much like my abyss. And then before I know it, I'm staring into my own abyss. And the next thing I know, 2 hours have gone. And my jaw hurts from grinding my teeth. And the inside of my cheeks are bleeding. And my lips look like the surface of the moon. And all I can feel is helplessness about not being able to help anyone at all. And yet, that I can deal with. When people on the internet are in my inbox with negativity or saying that they need help or that they're pleading that I can do something, I can deal with that. Because those emotions, I understand. Those emotions, I am intimately familiar with. Been there, done that. What I cannot handle on the internet is all the fucking positivity. Dear citizens of Instagram, spare me. Spare me your colorful tiles with your short, cute quotes that sound so cool but don't say shit. Spare me all your amazing lies where you try to fit complex emotions and diverse struggles into cute shareable lines that sound really nice when you share them, but don't mean shit. I am tired of going online on an anxious day and seeing a post where someone said something like, unfuck yourself. Okay, how? What? That's the whole quote? What a fine coincidence. Because unfuck yourself is not advice. Unfuck yourself is something that you scream when you've had too much Red Bull before you skydive. So please stop. Spare me. Spare me your Monday motivation. Spare me this lie that you have told yourself that happiness is the ideal, that happiness is the default. That any deviation from its pursuit is a sign of abnormality. I don't know if people told you this or not, but the opposite of happy is not wrong. You're not preaching positivity, you're preaching denial. Stop telling people who are dealing with shit, whether it's depression or whether it's anxiety or whatever it is, stop telling them shit like, oh, that's just another beautiful dimension of you. Stop telling me that that's just a beautiful scar that I carry. There is nothing beautiful about it. There is nothing beautiful about seeing blood in your foam when you brush your teeth every morning. There is nothing beautiful about wondering what your friends and family are up to because you don't have the courage to walk out of your front door on a particular day. Stop telling people things like it is not you who is depressed, it is reality which is broken. The next time you're sick, I'll come to your house, throw your medicines out of the window and say it is not you who has malaria. It is mosquitoes who are assholes. So how about for 2 seconds we put aside your relentless engines of positivity and we engage with the complexity of the truth? So I don't know who needs to hear this, but I'm going to say it. If you're out there and you're dealing, I want to say this. Dear person, I know it sucks. I know it's scary. I know you feel like the undertow is pulling you in, and I know you feel like you're drowning. And I am sorry that you have to deal with it at all. I want to tell you that things will get better soon, but I don't know your life story. I don't know your struggle. I don't know the severity of your illness, and I cannot make you a patronizing promise like that. What I can say is that hopefully one day at some point in your future, it will get better. That one point when you feel like giving up, just remember that somewhere in your future, maybe not tomorrow, maybe not day after, maybe not next year, but somewhere in your future, a day is waiting, and it is a simple and ordinary and profound day where you'll get one little thing right, like you'll make the perfect cup of tea. Or the sun and the wind will hit your face in that perfectly pleasant way that makes you want to take a lovely nap. Or a friend will tell a joke that will make you burst out in laughter. And in that second, on that day, a voice in your head will say, I'm glad I stuck around for this. I am glad I fought off the abyss. I am glad that I stared it down. And I am glad that I am here. I will also tell you that that day will not last and it will go away. And for every good day, there will be another bad one because this is who we are. We will wander between the darkness and the light, and that's okay. And when you feel like you're weak or at your weakest and you should give up, remember that you might think you're weak, but you are someone else's source of strength, whether you know it or not. And what we have, what we deal with, what we live with, it isn't always nice and it isn't always pretty. But it is. You are. And you really should stay. Anxiously yours, Rohan.